Session 10, Breakthrough.
One of these lives, I'ma make these right with the wrongs I done. That's when I unite with the Father, Son, till then I fight. Rain on me, put the blame on me. Got guilt, got hurt, got shame on me. Got 6 magazines that's aimed at me. Done every magazine
morning.
Was
fame to me. It is Tuesday, December 13th, 2022. Getting ready for a 2-mile run. Tired run. So, legs are good. Not as sore from yesterday, but we'll see how it is when we do run. Ah, refreshing. So, just did my 2-mile run. Finished in 17 minutes and 31 seconds. That's got to be the fastest 2-mile time for me. Like I said, improvements. I believe our last 2-mile time, let me double check for you guys so I won't get it wrong. Let's double check. Our last 2-mile was an 8:28. So big improvement. Super big improvement. Almost a minute off. So that's good. Like I said, I'm still sweating due to the fact that I just barely finished. But, you know, I'm proud of myself. I was sitting down in the back, just reflecting how far I've came so far. It's a lot of improvements. It's feels good. I feel good. You know, my body's feeling good. I feel skinny, but I still got the dad bod. But you know what? As long as I'm feeling better, I'm feeling like I feel skinnier overall, even though I've only lost, like I said, a couple pounds. But I'm still working on it, you know. So, like I said, I'm proud of myself. I'm proud of everything I'm doing. You know, sometimes you just got to sit back and admire the stuff you've done so far and just keep pushing.
So as you can see, the 2-mile run that we just did in 17 minutes and 31 seconds, it was pretty good. You know, started off a little bit too quick on this corner, but kept it at a steady pace. You can't really tell between the green and red, but as you can see, we did pretty good. Like I said, it was our fastest 2 miles, 17:31. So that is very good. Our last 2-mile time, we're going to show you, is a 18:28, the same school. So improvement, which I love to see, and I'm glad we're seeing this. And I'm feeling better on those 2-mile fast runs or 2.5 mile full runs. So I'm feeling faster. It's feeling a lot better, which I'm happy about. So I hope you know, we just keep going up. We just keep improving from here on out.
Good morning. I believe it's December 14th. Could be wrong. Could be the 13th, to be honest with you. I'm out here walking my dog. Today's the day off from running, so that's a good thing. But like I said, you see the park we're at, you know, nice and peaceful, you know, nice and relaxing. So the days I'm not running, I do come walk my dog on a long walk. So probably like 2 miles. So not that bad, just to get my legs moving, because I don't want to be laying down most of the days. I usually don't record on my off days when I'm running, so I'm gonna try to record as much as I do today. Today I'm just gonna get another haircut. As you can see, I am going to Vegas, so that's gonna be next week. So that's gonna be something interesting, because we got to keep running and it's gonna be cold over there, so probably a lot of treadmill work over there. I'm going to Vegas for my brother's tournament, and I'll get more into it in a bit. Yeah, so I mean, as you can see, it's a beautiful park. Super beautiful. Got my dog here. I don't know if I've introduced you guys. Her name is Leia. She is a black lab. She's just turned 3. Yeah, she just turned 3. So 3 years old in October. But yeah, as you can see, it's very nice, chill park by the freeway. Not where I live. It's about like 15-10 minutes away. But yeah, let me switch over to face cam. But yeah, I'm leaving next Monday. So before I upload this week's video, the next video would be me going to Vegas. But yeah, so I gotta keep everything ready on lock, because I gotta still run out there, because I'll be there Monday to Thursday, and I do run Tuesdays and Thursdays. I could probably fit in a run on Monday. Depends. We still got to do this weekend. It's a 5 mile run instead of a 6.5. So it won't be too bad. It should actually be pretty easy somewhat. But yeah, we just got to keep it going even on vacation. Like I said, I'm going for my brother's basketball tournament. He's a senior. So I have to go to these, you know, basketball games. This last season of basketball, so I gotta make sure I go to all of them. But yeah, it should be fun. I mean, it should be a nice little trip, just to get away, you know, for a bit, a couple days, watch some basketball. But I still gotta keep grinding, you know. I can't take those days off. That's 4 days off right there if I don't run and do anything at all. So yeah. So we just finished our walk. As you can see, she's tired. It was a mile and a half. I did let her go off leash. I haven't done it in a while. I trust her. It's just other dogs around. But luckily this park today didn't have a lot of dogs out and about. But she's tired. She's thirsty. I started swaying a little bit. Look at that. Look at these gray hairs, man. I'm getting old. But yeah, so we're just gonna go back home, eat some breakfast. It's let me double check the time. It's 10 o'clock. So go home, eat some breakfast. I've been craving In-N-Out, so I don't know if we're gonna get that for lunch. But yeah, let's go home and get some food, man. Good morning. It is December 15th. I was right yesterday about the date. This time I know I'm right. But yeah, it's December 15th. We're getting ready for a 4 mile run. Let me get a quick water bottle. Sorry about the decorations in the background. I mean, you can't tell because it's backwards, but there's some whole holes in this house. But yeah, we had my sister had a Christmas party. But yeah, we're filling up the bottle. Get our shake ready. Not a shake. It's not a shake. But yeah, got a haircut yesterday. Getting ready for Vegas. Barber kind of fucked up my... I can't grow facial hair as much. I can't grow a full beard out. So the only thing I was able to grow that took me a while was my mustache. Even though it wasn't thick, you know, kind of messed it up yesterday. I'm not going to blame him, but he kind of cut one side a little more than the other side. So I had to shave it off. So, but it's okay. I'm fine with that. Gotta start off brand new, you know. Getting the shake in. Boom, bada, bing. After this, brush our teeth, stretch, get our clothes ready. Usually, I don't brush my teeth before drinking this because then give me a weird flavor. Doesn't taste as good as it's supposed to. But yeah, for today, like I said, 4 mile run. Today we're gonna take it. I kind of wanna push myself like on a good pace, but at the same time, I'm not too sure if that will work. Sorry that my dog's crying. She wants to go outside. She just woke up too. But like I said, I wanna go on a good pace, but at the same time, I am having my left knee is bothering me just a little bit, like a tad bit. But I'll see on that first mile. That's how I know how my runs are gonna go. It depends on the first mile. But yeah, let's see what we gotta do. Gotta stay fresh, gotta stay warm. It's a little cold outside still. Yeah, man, let's get this fucking 4 mile run done, man. So just got to the park. Doing the quick stretch before we take off and run. Like I said, 4 miles should be pretty easy, but at the same time, you can't underestimate 4 miles. Sorry if you see me like this. Going on, I'm stretching my ankles. Oh, the camera's falling. Caught it. But yeah, stretching my ankles out. Usually I never really stretched my ankles out till I seen Nick Bear's video. He was stretching his ankles out, so I started doing that as well.
yeah, I learned a lot of things from him. Running, stretching, like I said, I got motivated from him and all that. So I'm glad I did. But yeah, man, let's get this 4 mile done. Let's get this shit done.
So I'm keeping a quicker pace than usual. We're gonna try it out today, see how it goes. Yeah, so far I feel good.
All done. 4 miles. Whew. Did our 4 miles in. Hold up, saving up. Says we got a new record. It's our fastest 5K. So that's good. 4 miles in 43 minutes and 22 seconds. So not too bad. I did stop once to use the restroom because I had to go pee. But other than that, I mean, we did start off pretty strong. But towards the end, I kind of felt fatigued and tired. So I think for these runs, I'm starting to not take them as an easy run, because it's supposed to be an easy run. So I'm kind of going out of my plan and not making an easy run. So that's my fault. I got to listen to the plan that we're doing. But other than that, 4 miles done. I'm dripping in sweat. Time to change and time to go home. So as you can see, we just did our 4 mile run, 43 minutes and 23 seconds. As you can see, new personal best. It's gonna be our best 5K time. Our previous was 33 and 5 minutes, so that's good. But this is the bad thing. Look at this, red. Totally, like I said, I slowed down towards the end, which is a good thing, because as you can see, I was going way too fast. So no wonder why I felt super tired. It didn't feel like a good run. Honestly, this whole run wasn't good. I gotta take it slow. It is supposed to be an easy run, as you can see right here on the top. It says Los Angeles County easy run. It's a moderate run, so we're gonna put that. We already accepted our previous best. But yeah, too quick. Way too quick for an easy run. Easy run should be a little bit of the light blue or just right on the green. So it wasn't good. Aerobic was fine, you know, we're sitting there. But yeah, it's just like I said, man, it wasn't a good run. I didn't feel like a good run. My times were 10:27, 10:26, slow down at 11 and 11:27. Yeah, man, like I said, not a good run. Even though I did finish quicker, I think my last 4 mile run, let's see. Running. Let's go. We got to go to a year. Did we do anything this, a 4 mile run anytime soon? Yeah, so 4 mile run. If it loads up, taking a little slow. There it is. So that was a 43:42. As you can see, a lot better. A whole lot better, actually. So compare that, a 43:42 to a 43:22, which is all red. So overall, wasn't a good run. But yeah, as you can see, for sleep, we're going to be going over sleep as soon as I get home. I did get BPN's new, that's not new, but it's called Peak Sleep. I've used it for 2 days already, and I'll tell you how I feel about it, and I'll show you how it's packaged and everything else. So, just got home. About to feed my dog, because she's hungry. I'm hungry. Finna eat breakfast. Probably go on a walk later on with my dog. But yeah, man. Like I said, 4 mile run. Done. Tomorrow, 2 mile run. Video's gonna upload. Probably, I'll probably upload the video on Saturday. If not, we'll do the long run on Sunday and upload it on Sunday. But yeah, so far, man, ups and downs, ups and downs. But gotta keep pushing, gotta keep working. All right, so I was gonna talk about Peak Sleep by Bear Performance Nutrition. It's gonna be backwards. You guys are gonna, it's gonna be hard to see backwards, but peak sleep, nighttime sleep support. So the past two nights, I've took it, and it says right here, let me double check it. It says peak sleep is our nighttime sleep support supplement created to improve your sleep quality and recovery for those experiencing difficult sleeping. So these past week and a half, I kind of have been having problems going to sleep. I've been staying up to like 1-2 in the morning, which is not good, because like you have to sleep to get your, for your body to recover. And me not sleeping well, only getting about 4 or 5 hours of sleep is not going to do it. So it says right here, directions for use. Mix one serving, one scoop, in 8 to 10 ounces of hot or cold water. I just drink it regular temperature water, and consume 30 to 45 minutes before bed. So that's what I usually do. I think it would taste a little better with it being hot. It is chocolate flavor, so it is good. Let's see, I believe it's supposed to be 30 servings, so that's not too bad. It was $40. A lot of people will say that's a little too much for them. They could just get melatonin gummies and all, but I've never taken those melatonin gummies. This is the first time I've tried something for me to help go to sleep quicker, and it has helping me go to sleep quicker. I will pull up the stats for my last two nights on my Garmin app watch. My Garmin watch app, yeah. But yeah, I'll go over it with you guys. I believe I got a total of 8+ hours of sleep, or more than 8 hours, which is good compared to like 4 or 5 hours that I'll be getting. But one thing today that I did realize is that when I woke up around 6:30, because I was gonna go running at 6:30, I was still tired. Like I felt super tired. Like I just wanted to go back to sleep. So that's what I did. I went back to sleep, woke up, still got the run done, which you guys seen the 4-mile run. But yeah, peak sleep BPN. I'm gonna give it another couple of days, but as of now, I do recommend it. It's true to its words, like 30 to 45 minutes before you sleep. I start feeling sleepy, start yawning, and then next thing you know, I'm asleep. Sometimes it's the first time I took it, I didn't even know, like, I just fell sleepy and boom, lights out, I was knocked out. But yeah, so if you guys have any problems sleeping, or just wanna, you know, get something to help you sleep quicker, to go to sleep quicker, recommend Peak Sleep by BPN. But yeah, there's no ad or anything, I'm just saying. So here we're on the Garmin app. This was today's sleep. As you can see, a total of 8 hours and 22 minutes of sleeping. I was in deep sleep for 56 minutes, light sleep for 6 hours and 20 minutes, and REM for 1 hour and 6 minutes. I was awake, I told you, early in the morning when I woke up to go running, but I didn't. I went back to sleep. So 8 hours is pretty good for me. And this was yesterday on Wednesday. I had 1 hour and 35 minutes total for deep sleep. Is 1 hour and 9 minutes. Light, 6 hours and 6 minutes. Where I'm 1 hour and 20, and I was only up for 36 minutes. But those two nights are the nights that I took in the supplement to go to sleep, to help me sleep. Right here, and I didn't take it here. I didn't have it yet, but I got, you know, pretty decent good of sleep. 7 hours and 22 minutes. And this is where you see that's not good at all. 5 hours and 15 minutes. This on Sunday was the best sleep I've ever had in my life, as you can see. 10 hours and 54 minutes. I knocked out at 9:51 and woke up at 9:50, so that's pretty crazy. But yeah, you know, getting those 8 hours of sleep, you know, comes in clutch. So like I said, I recommend getting it, and I hope you guys get it, and I hope it helps you guys sleep. Yo, so that's gonna be the end of the video. I am going to Vegas 2 days, so I'll be vlogging a lot more. But yeah, so hope you guys enjoy the video. Please like, subscribe. Hello, when you count me out, fuck it up, fucking it up. How you gonna win my trust when the last run?